7 years ago, we experienced the loss of our infant, Briar. She was 4 months old, and my husband and I were both at work, and we received a phone call from our babysitter that she had stopped breathing while she was there. When we arrived at the hospital, we had gotten more information and realized that she had fallen asleep just briefly in a swing when she stopped breathing. You try to do positive things to help other people and really just bring awareness, because I think people don't really understand that just a few minutes in a swing can result in something so devastating to your family.
SIDS stands for Sudden Infant Death Syndrome, and it affects about 14% of children under one. The recommended safe sleep guidance is to be alone on your back in a crib. Some other recommendations are not co-sleeping, to keep the room at a comfortable temperature so that your baby is not too warm. It's also recommended to sleep with a pacifier and also without any smoking in the home.
It's important to not only tackle just the parents. Oftentimes it's going to be like a multi-generational approach to changing the thought process around safe sleep. 20 years ago, all of our parents will tell you that babies were supposed to be put on their stomach because if they were to spit up, then it would come out. But as we have learned and as we've looked at the anatomy and just basic science of how the body functions, we know that's not true. Back is best because of anatomy and gravity, that fluid will flow right back into their stomach. Safe Sleep Simulation was founded out of the innovation team at Parkview in the Muro Center. And we were founded from the innovation competition that is held every year. And that was developed with our community health workers in conjunction with our nurse navigation team and Healthier Moms and Babies. So when the program started, our primary audience was community health workers, home visitors, and hospitals. From there, we found the growth and interest in educating others, including our middle school health curriculum and babysitting courses. We decided that we thought it would be a good idea to take this project to the AMP Lab as a project for their students to work on and look at making some marketing materials that helped reach a younger audience. A lot of these infants are taken care of by siblings and younger kids, babysitting them after school on the weekends. And unfortunately, sleep-related deaths happen under the care of some of these children. So eventually that should be able to feed into future generations, hopefully making a difference in sleep-related deaths.
It's important to tell Briar's story because obviously we know safe sleep practices are so very important. And I know a lot of family members, including grandparents and even moms and dads for that matter, that say, oh, my child slept in a crib on their belly their whole entire life and they're fine, or they slept in a swing for the first 6 months of their lives, but it only takes one time and just seconds for something to go so wrong. In my role as a practice manager over specialty care, I think it's amazing what Muro is doing with this safe sleep innovation and the outreach to our communities and our younger mothers. Our community and our patients would be more aware when they come to our OB offices for their very first prenatal visit, and they will be successful in taking care of an infant and caring for them during safe sleep practices.